head that reminds you that I'm going to die one day. I mean, have you really taken the time to think about it? And I'm not trying to make this poem a morbid, tense moment, but just for a few minutes, just try to fathom this fact. That the air that we breathe is fleeting with every exhale like a leaf blowing in a continuous whirlwind, never to return again. That our heart is beating like a runner in a marathon, though the pace is slow and steady, it's still destined to come to the finish line.
Yeah. Yeah.
That our blood travels with precise consistency, but will soon turn cold, and our veins will run dry like empty riverbeds. See, our eyes are strong and vivid with such intensity, but will eventually set sight on either our creator or our destroyer. You see, the saying goes nowadays, you only live once. An excuse to do whatever you feel, whatever seems right, whatever brings you the most happiness for the moment. See, this concept leaves a man who has reached his alcohol limit, leaving him one shot away from being hospitalized for alcohol poisoning. Or a boy so consumed with his hormones has him knocking at the door of a sexually transmitted disease grave, or a girl so lost in her insecurity, placing her at the hands of revealing pictures on Facebook just to tiptoe around suicide a few moments later. Death.
Yeah.
You see, death is the absence of life.
Yeah.
That final test for all of us, that old dusty trail, that stairway to heaven, that cabin in the sky, the long ride home, a postdated payment that we all will have to pay someday.
Yeah.
You see, death is a curse.
Yes.
Ever since Adam ate of the fruit and was banished from the garden, just to have his clock start ticking that was never meant to tick.
Yeah.
Just imagine an immortal being that never understood or knew about the concept of death, so all of a sudden feel this drifting away begin in the depths of his soul after he bit of the fruit.
Come on, sir.
And being who was never meant to age, start aging, this vulnerability of his immune system to the elements around him, this loss of dominion, waking up that next day after having fallen from the presence of God, looking his wife Eve in the eyes with such curiosity and asking her, when will it happen?
Yeah.
Then Adam lives 930 years and finally it's here and Adam dies. And though the scriptures don't say it, he probably witnessed the death of his wife Eve. The guilt, the shame, the burden that he must have felt knowing that he was the reason his family, his children, their children, and every single generation that come would face the mysterious moment of transition called death.
Yeah.
You see, death is a wage that begs to be given yet. We live life as if we are going to live forever. Plan what we're going to do tomorrow, a week from now, a month from now, 5 years from now, 20 years from now, but don't know if we're going to live to see the next 15 minutes.
Yeah.
You see, I'm reminded of a story of a boy named Rashid. College basketball hopeful, Division I promise, hardwood floors and glass backboard dreamer. $30 million checks await him after his first year of college ball, but they were never deposited because his brain became the final resting place of a stray bullet that was shot during a drive-by, two weeks shy of his high school graduation. While I'm reminded of a man by the name of William, a Wall Street tycoon, investment banker, luxury car driver, fine dining, private jet flyer. He was supposed to meet his wife and three kids in Maui that next day, but was witnessing a Boeing 757 airplane coming straight towards his office window on a dreary September morning. I'm also reminded of Allie, a mother-to-be, wife of Steve, nurse practitioner, thinking about transitioning to become a stay-at-home mother. She's ready and excited to meet her daughter, Savannah, but after that last contraction and that final push, she never opened her eyes and never heard her daughter's cries for the first time. You see, death is that guaranteed moment we all will meet, and every day we zero in on it like a sniper closes in on a target, but we choose not to think about this moment. Only putting it aside for the elderly and people with terminal disease, but I'm sure Dr. King wasn't thinking about it when he stepped out onto his balcony to get a breath of fresh air in Memphis, or when Trayvon Martin went to go purchase some Arizona iced tea and Skittles, or when Tupac was leaving for his Las Vegas hotel. I'm sure they wasn't thinking about the next moment that they will meet death.
Yeah.
You see, Jesus, the only person who knew the exact moment, time, and method he would die. So what if you knew the exact moment, time, and method you would die? Some of us would just fade off into our sleep. Others will suffer violence and tragedy. Some of us will contact deadly diseases. But if you knew how you would die, what would you do differently? Would fear leave your vocabulary? Would mediocrity become your enemy? Would procrastination turn into earth and CC? What would you do differently? And I don't know when or how I might leave this earth, but I do know that God has charged us with purpose, and only what we do for him will last. And it would be a shame if I left this earth and didn't do anything to fulfill my reason for being created. It would be utter despair if Christ never hung his head on that old rugged cross. So just fathom that for a second. You see, this earth is full of eagles who are meant to soar with the stars but are just content with the chicken coop because they didn't realize their full potential. This earth is full of eagles who are meant to soar with the stars but are content with the chicken coop because they have never realized their full potential. There is no reason why we shouldn't be walking amongst clouds right now. There is no reason we shouldn't be back spinning in the cosmos right now. So do that thing that you've always wanted to do for God, and don't just live to die. Live to inspire. Live to create. Live to bring glory to our Father in heaven. Sir. And let your moment of transition leave an eternal footprint that will cause the next generation to fly just a little bit higher than you did.
Yes, sir. Awesome.